We're going to see how to use MateCat. Let's see, first we have to get into MateCat. We just open it up. And it actually doesn't ask you to log in, but I have logged in just using my Google account. Okay, but you can use any other account that you want. Now, MateCat has a new interface, which is why I'm doing this new tutorial. We want to translate some subtitles. So I'm going to create a project, subtitles. I'm going to do it, not with anybody else, but you can add other people there. And these subtitles, yes, they're going from Portuguese into English. And I haven't created a memory for it, so I'll do that now. Okay, I click on there and I can see that, yes, I'm going to have machine translation working, and they say where it's from, Google Translate and Microsoft Translator. They're being nice and honest about that. And I'm going to create my own translation memory. Okay, so I'm going to call this here translation theory, because that's what this one's about. Sorry about that. And I want to look it up and I want to update it. Okay, and I'll confirm that. If we wanted to, we can import a TMX file, but that's for later on, okay? So we've done that. Advanced settings, we don't need the dictation yet, and the rest is fine, okay? Here we are. Now, I've got to go and get my ST, which is this one up here. It's actually some subtitles that somebody in Brazil has sent to me for a video that I did, and they've done them in Portuguese. You can see here there are tons of different formats that MateCat will work with, and I'm using an SRT format here. They haven't got an ASS format for subtitles, so you might have to convert the ASS into SRT in order for it to work, but there's tons of other formats available for you. Good, we've uploaded the file. They now want to analyze it because they want to offer a commercial translation for it, I think. Okay, I've just said how many repeat words are. We don't have to bother about that. I'm going to do it by myself. We don't have to split it up, but you could split it up if you want several translators to work on it. And I'm not going to buy a translation, because I know how to do it myself. We just click on translate. And we're in. Okay. So I've got the Portuguese there. I've got 100% match coming from the translation memory. And it's fine. There's a symbol mismatch. I can't see where that's happening. Yes, okay, that's fine. It's just broken it up there, and it's broken it up there because it's subtitles. They've got the line break put in there, okay? But we're going to go ahead with it, which is not as bad as people make it out to be. This is a very good machine translation. I actually prefer that, because Americans like that rather than which, unless there's a comma before it. But let's go on. What you can see as you go on is there is the translation that they've worked with, which is coming from MT, okay, which is pretty good. And we've got fuzzy match translations from their database, okay? Not so far away as people think. It's not as bad as you may think, okay? Translating this from Portuguese, 54%, 45%, those are pretty low fuzzy matches. So I'm going to stay with the 100% MT, which is good. And I just click translated and we move on. I hope that I presented the issue as something complex. Yes, that's good. I'm going to make it a bit more explicit though. Again, there's a symbol mismatch because of the line break. I wonder if I should put that in there. No, it's okay. I'll leave it there. I might have to go along afterwards when I see the subtitles with the video and put in some line breaks. Okay? But for the moment, we'll just live with them. We have premises such as natural equivalence. I know that when I gave the lecture, I talked about paradigms, so I can put that in and back translate it. And so on. And you just go through the text. Directional equivalence, very good. Mandatory, no, I actually said obligatory. You see, the original English was obligatory. It comes into Portuguese, obrigatório, which is close to mandatory in the database. Let's see what they've got down here, though. No, they're not telling us very much at all. Okay, we've just got mandatory equivalence. I'll put it back and make it obligatory. Good, and so on. What you can see here is that we are basically post-editing empty because the matches are coming up from machine translation. All right, I can see how far I'm going through the text here. I can see how many words are there in the work to do. I can see how many are left to do. So I've got an idea of where I am. Okay, that's how you translate, basically, in MateCat.